Are you ready? Want us to start over? Okay, good.
Okay, minutes of the March meeting. Have you already reviewed them?
No, we haven't. I didn't mess up anything.
No, that's good.
Good job.
Any comments? Trying to be all efficient here.
Other than that, they're lovely minutes and she's...
Thank you very much.
Very nice.
Would anyone like to move to accept the March minutes?
Move to accept the March minutes?
Second?
I can't, because I wrote them.
Can I second it if I wasn't there?
I think we decided yes last time.
I think we just don't second it.
Oh.
I don't know what we do in that case.
Why can't you second it?
Because I wrote them. I don't think I can second them if I wrote them.
Well, this is a quandary.
I think I will second them because...
There we go.
It's better than someone who wasn't here, so let's just do that.
I don't see anything.
All in favor?
And I'm going to actually look that up.
Just because lack of quorum does create these little issues.
Exactly.
All right. Old business, fiscal year '17 budget, there's not much to say other than it was approved at town meeting on Tuesday night, which we actually finished town meeting overnight, which was...
Amazing.
Wonderful and amazing. It was late, but at least we got through it. So our budget is in a good place. We have enough money to meet state requirements and we'll be open Sunday again and it's all wonderful. And I will have an assistant director as of July 1st, which is really exciting. It's nice to get that promotion through.
Yes.
Since she's doing the work anyway, I'm glad.
Because she's doing the work anyway, exactly.
Yeah, recognized for it.
Exactly.
I'm sorry.
Kathy.
Kathy Bendy, yeah. She's been doing the work anyway.
Yeah.
So that's why I put forward the promotion, because she might as well get the credit.
Yes, definitely.
Director's report, is that next?
For, we have 2 months to do. We have April and May. No, March and April, sorry, there and there. So we actually have 2 months.
Let's do the both at once.
Okay, so we're doing April.
No, it would be the March minutes we're looking for.
I don't know if I have mine.
We missed April's meeting. That was March report, which is in the packet dated April 14th.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got one packet.
Oh, I missed a packet, I'm sorry. I was wondering why I couldn't find that. Here we go.
Thank you.
That's why I ended up with extras. Could you pass it down?
I I know it's March, when was that, the next time?
Oh, yeah. Okay. It wasn't 2016.
No biggie. We're the only ones seeing it, but I...
Well, I thought I fixed that, actually. Hope I didn't do that this week.
You didn't.
Oh, I took it off?
You didn't, but I didn't know if that mattered. I don't know if you're switching between your tablets.
Probably. All right. So we're doing April. Seems like an awfully long time ago.
March, right?
March, right. Well, the April, yes. I knew it was March.
The ebooks that you mentioned here, is this the one that we have withdrawn from the state ebooks thing?
Which one?
This right here. Are these numbers for that, or is that something?
No, these are, I didn't put those on.
Okay.
These are Overdrive, the ones we've always belonged to.
Right.
The two that say Advantage, those are the two we subscribe to now.
Okay, so the ebooks one, this is the one that's being phased out?
No, these are all Overdrive.
These are Overdrive, okay.
The first one, two, three, four is Overdrive.
All right, thank you.
Tumble Books is separate, and that'll be gone at the end of June.
Okay.
And the network's not carrying it, and the other two we fund.
Perfect. Thank you.
Non-resident borrowing went way up.
Yeah, for that month I was surprised, actually. That was a big jump.
And our borrowing went up.
It was a good month. You're just working on March, right? Are you looking at both at once?
I'm just looking at March right
now.
Let's accept them both at once, though.
Okay. Oh, that's fine.
Interesting that the local history room is being used much more often. And it ever has, like...
It goes through fits and spurts. Like some months, like this month. Did it use this month?
Three times.
Yeah. It's unusual. Sometimes nobody uses it, and then suddenly five or six people. There's no really rhyme or reason.
That's interesting.
Stephanie's been doing some research on it. She's been trying to find particular articles to promote on our Facebook page and our website.
That's cool.
Yeah, to try to sort of pique people's interest.
I was looking at something about the Cobb Library recently, and I noticed an old article that you had written for the website that had an old newspaper clipping from when this library was first established, with like how the rules for borrowing from the library. Right. And I thought it was really cool to actually have all that online. So that's cool. Good idea.
Yeah, so she's starting to do that. So if you want to see fun stuff online, I've been collecting old book plates and book pockets that used to be in old library books.
Yes.
It's really funny going back in time to see the limited hours, but the rules were strict, like you can't borrow them if, and don't you dare be late, and take care of your books, and it was very, I should bring some in someday.
Yeah, that
should be a project.
What do you mean old?
Your name was stamped.
early, as far back as the pockets are, I think the earliest pockets I've found is probably going back to the 30s.
Oh, that's okay.
I'd have to go look at them again.
Okay, I was hoping you weren't meaning the 2000s or the
1990s. No,
of course not. I even had them still in 2000s.
I did,
sadly.
But I took pockets, yeah.
Did they?
Oh, yeah, I worked in Halifax in 2007, and we were just, we still had
Wow. I miss them.
Me too.
Okay. I noticed the new copier.
It's nice.
It works very nicely. I don't like to have to reach and figure out where my papers are coming out, though, because it kind of disappears into the middle of the machine.
It does.
Which I think is weird, but it works really well.
Yeah, it does. I find that too. I'm always like, okay, where are
you? Yeah, like I looked in, like, where are they
I agree, I find that kind of...
But it's, it works very well.
Yes, yeah.
So that's cool.
Good images, yes.
I didn't know they were even doing that, so that's very cool.
It's very, very wonderful purchase by the Friends. Very supportive.
Okay, we're accepting at the same time?
Yep. So now we're looking at April.
Can I have April, please?
Oh, you don't have April?
I don't have April? Well, I went over mine, so...
That's April.
This is why we should never skip meetings, because it's...
And I didn't packet them together when we skip a meeting in the summer. I put it together as one package, but I had already had last month's already.
Right.
So... And I did not repackage them, so...
Resident and non-resident borrowing up again.
Oh, we didn't see the carpet.
Hmm?
We didn't see the carpet yet.
Oh, you should go see the carpet. It really looks nice. Really looks nice.
No one commented on it in puppy dog tails today.
Wow.
I was like, you've all been here so many times.
Carpet looks so nice. Yeah. I don't think Yoga mentioned it, and they're on it.
Yeah, but to be fair, I think that dogs were involved, right? Wasn't that like Reggie?
I know, it was like they were
probably... They're looking at dogs, they're not going to notice the carpet.
We have three dogs, and normally we only have two.
Yeah.
The golden retriever was there, no one sees anything else.
Right.
New carpet, dogs?
Yes, well, I was just thinking.
I know, I'm like pretty brave.
Don't they have to mark those things?
You're going to have to do it.
But the carpet looks amazing.
Look at therapy dogs, very well trained. Just sort of sit there.
Stephanie just had a painting program in there, I'm like, don't spill anything.
She came in and asked me for a tablecloth.
I told her to.
She's like, I'm paranoid. It'll be fine. There are dogs.
Do you have extra squares?
Yes.
Yeah.
You do.
That's going to have to happen at some point.
Right. Of course. But not the first one, please.
They were, maintenance at our place was looking for carpet squares because they have to redo an area of us where there are not currently squares. And I said, office where I used to work. Check by the file cabinets, like put them there.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, I have to move ours upstairs because right now they're just in the way.
Okay.
This is the first time you guys have been in this room with the lights officially, correct?
Yes.
Don't they look wonderful?
Very nice.
You don't like them?
No, I said that's what's different.
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
I think it's brighter.
I feel like they weren't here last time I was here.
No, they looked
They weren't here. No, they just finished.
Yeah.
I don't think they were here. Let's see, we didn't meet last month.
Even the switches are different.
Yeah, I don't think they were here last.
No, maybe not.
No, because the last time we talked about that they needed to finish it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're great.
And this room was the last one we did, so. Yeah.
The ones that were most noticeable to me were above the circulation baskets.
Yeah.
How this brightness is...
Well, I never use them
Amazing.
Because we're trying to save electricity.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
It'll be interesting over the coming months to see if the kilowatts actually go down as
it
promised.
It
will be interesting. You guys all reading The Martian?
I'm going to be, yes.
All right.
As soon as I finish my glasses, I'm all out.
It's so funny when I go back to write these reports. I forgot that we closed one day in April. We closed early that night. Wow, it was snowing in April.
Mm-hmm.
Thankfully, it seems long ago.
Well, in 77, it snowed here in April.
I know, it has snowed.
Because I remember being home and there was a sign in Florida with about 4 inches of snow on it, and that made the paper up there.
Yeah, no, I know it snowed later. I still don't like seeing snow in April.
So I would like to move to accept the March and April director's reports.
Anyone second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, youth services.
For March.
For March and then April. Thank you. I was like, why was
I just remember I got a compliment on the underwater robotics, and I cannot remember. Oh, Shelley. Was she here that day? She must have been.
What is Shelley's? Was
the Boy Lab Christmas.
Oh, yes, she was
that
here.
That was the day she came.
I thought you meant one of the parents.
No.
Yeah, she was here.
Yeah.
And
she said that was fabulous. She loved it.
She said I should have been a teacher. I was like, I'm a librarian for a reason.
There's a closeness there.
It's, I know it's a
yes, it is.
And this energy
tic-tac-toe. I was literally like just running around. I was like, oh my gosh, you got two ping pong balls in there. You just need one more. I was like,
it was fine. The teachers were just sort of looking at me like,
what's wrong with this one?
And the kids were like, oh my gosh, let's go there.
Yeah.
So it's fun.
Yeah, whatever works.
Yeah.
Do the adults at chess club, do they play or are they normally?
They, it's a mix. Usually they'll just sort of sit off to the side and like do their knitting or talk to each other. But sometimes they'll actually play like against each other or against their kids, and it's so cute. So it just varies from week to week.
Second challenge.
So it's sort of an online internet phenomenon, and basically you're given a challenge and then you hit play and you have to do that thing in 7 seconds or and you either win or lose. And like the examples, I did some examples, and one was like make 3 animal noises and name them as you go. I failed it because I just blanked. I was like, oh, I can't think of another animal. So it's high pressure, and they loved it. They just kept coming back. Back.
Candyland and Apples to Apples, are those the physical games or those?
They're the physical games. We have a little board and card game collection under the video games, and I'll just bring them out.
And that's in the young adult lounge?
Yes, because we've got our own gaming collection in the children's room as well. Much bigger, but we have a lot of babies over there. I bought Chutes and Ladders because Candyland was so popular. I was like, you need some Chutes and Ladders.
I was surprised. I like Candyland.
Oh, I got it on a whim just from a thrift shop. I was like, oh, here you go.
Well, I
have
got a
fun.
Whole bunch of games at home that I
think of. Love games.
Are you on April?
Who's
I am.
Lunch?
Yes.
Everybody else is.
Yeah. I just wanted to remind them to just lock up and leave us in here.
Yes.
So it's
really nice.
I don't think anybody else is coming.
I'm going to the Kidbridge Preschool Art Show.
It's still up.
Is it?
No, it's gone.
It's gone?
Because it was only up for a month, and they wanted to get the pieces back to the kids.
That was so nice.
So nice.
So that's a cute idea, I like that.
They were adorable.
It was really nice. That's really cool. To have that, to be able to see it hung up like that, must be pretty cool.
They were very happy. Like, people were coming, because they're like, oh, we can't make the open house. Is it okay if we just look? I was like, yes, please.
Father brought in his couple of kids to look.
That's cool.
It was nice work, too.
How did the kids do with the electric drills?
Fine. There was one girl I was so nervous about. She had super long hair, and so it draped in front of her face. And we're like, maybe you should go get a ponytail or a headband. Yeah, after we saw that, it was like, oh, it's fine. But, yeah, she was very careful. Apparently, her dad's a carpenter. She's like, I do this every day. Good, I'm glad.
What kind of beads for the summer program?
Oh, like just pony beads.
Oh.
Very nice. A lot of them. Everyone should be doing it. So successful.
So. What kind of beads did you say?
We do pony beads. They get the beads to decorate necklaces we give out at the beginning.
Okay.
Did you do that last year?
Yes. So I'm presenting on it this year. And hopefully everyone will be like, such a good idea, let's do it. And we're going to do it again this year. Got new tags and everything.
Nice.
Would anyone like to move to accept the
services
reports?
I move to accept the reports.
And I will second it then.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Didn't go very well, did it?
No.
It's too bad.
POV films seem to be crashing and burning.
Is it the time or is it the material?
We're not getting any feedback. I think it's material. Our very first one was about Alzheimer's, and she got a lot of response. So she was so excited. She said, this is going to be great. I said, that's wonderful. And then she did it again, and nobody came. And nobody's been coming in. It's too bad. And then this last one, Herman's House, seemed really interesting and got a lot of publicity. We put it all over Facebook, a lot of comments and some shares. Still not the game.
It's kind of funny because I haven't seen anything about that, and I subscribed to all the
library channels,
and I see most of the stuff, and I saw nothing about that.
Oh, I saw them.
So yes. I'm wondering if maybe people just
weren't aware, even though it was more publicity than usual. Because normally I don't miss anything, and I didn't say anything about it, honestly.
Documentaries and independent films are a tough sell here. I tried them a few years ago, I remember, based on request. So I subscribed to those independent film series, and I got them every month, and I showed them, and initially it started with a small but dedicated core group, and then they just fizzled to nothing.
Yeah.
So, I mean, she's going to keep trying. She has no control over the subject matter. I think they just, you subscribe and they just send.
Right.
As far as I know. So,
but again, Thursday nights.
Interesting.
Is it always Thursday nights that she's been doing?
I mean, we can try it, but again, it's not like we got feedback. It was originally Thursday night, but we had to cancel that Thursday night because of the carpet.
Okay.
So we moved it to Monday so that we could still show it. But we haven't gotten any feedback saying, oh, I would come if it were a different night.
I feel like Mondays might be better because people usually have more to do by the end of the week. But people might not want to be going out and doing that on a Monday night.
In this town,
you know?
There's a lot going on Monday night.
Yeah, is there? Okay.
Yeah. There's a lot of committees and meetings.
Oh, that's right.
Stuff.
All the meetings are Mondays.
Right,
never mind.
On Monday night. So Mondays are tough here, I think.
That's true.
So, I mean, I'm not against Monday nights, but...
Yeah, I wasn't thinking about it. Is it one Monday a month, or is it every week that they have the... Is there
something
every
Monday? This comes every Monday.
That would explain that.
Yeah. So it's kind of tricky. Mondays are tricky. But that was on a Monday, and nobody came. But we can try different nights. Let's see. I don't know what we're getting for this month. Hope we get an audience. We're going to show The Martian.
It's a great movie.
Some of my teens were talking about that yesterday.
Yay.
Yeah, they were like, one of them said, oh, have you seen that new movie with the guy and it's in space? And I was like, do you mean The Martian? I'm like, yeah, that's the one. And she was so excited about it. She was like, oh, you have to go see us. I said, oh, you know, we're showing that here. She's like, we have to come, Isabella, we have to come.
Oh, nice.
So
there will be popcorn.
I know.
Okay. There will be popcorn.
What is the date?
How do you do the popcorn? Microwave. Not in the staff microwave. No, not in the staff microwave. In the public microwave. And just put it in a big bowl. And the piranha eat them, and we fill the bowl. We put out popcorn for Melissa's kids one day, and before we put the bowl on the table, the popcorn was gone. I was like, wait a minute. What just happened here?
These children
in Pembroke. Well, yeah. I think that's part of it.
Was that for Good Dinosaur?
Yes.
Yeah.
It was the lunchtime program. Next time we'll serve sandwiches.
Okay, do you know what galaxy jars are?
No. Yeah, I wanted to do those. Those were tonight.
Oh, those
galaxy
were tonight.
I shouldn't have told you that they were scheduled the night of our meeting.
I know.
I don't know. They were jars. They had glow-in-the-dark paint.
There was glow-in-the-dark paint.
There
are jars and glow-in-the-dark paint, and you paint the inside of the jars. A bunch of people, how many people? 12, maybe-ish?
She said she had 12 signed up, no, 13 by the time it started.
Yeah.
That looked really cool.
The Martian film showing will be on Tuesday, May 24th at 6 p.m. Mark Watney, Stranded on Mars.
Actually, I should bring in, have you picked up our Tom Wybie flyers? Perhaps I will bring some. I'll be right back.
It's a long movie. How long is it going to be keeping people in here? I feel like it was long.
It was pretty long. I enjoyed it immensely.
It was great.
It was like so
I loved
intense.
It. Loved it.
I liked it more than the book, I think.
I haven't read the book yet, but I'm going to.
And the Martian.
The movie?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, no, that's interesting because some people said they liked the book more you had more of his thoughts about
what's going on. I liked it because I could see what he was doing.
Yep.
It's a very intense science at work there.
I didn't know that you want to know.
Thank you.
The display on the front table is nice. And a lot of the books have gone out, which is really nice.
Yes, I was going to say, I grabbed a copy off the front table, and when I got home, my son grabbed it from me.
knew it was going to happen. Bound to happen. This is going to make riveting film.
I was reading the entire time. Hey, it's a library meeting.
It's a library meeting. What do they do with the library meeting? They read. I could always send them out earlier. I might do that. I might start doing that.
Yeah, but we're not going to read them beforehand.
Well, that's true.
No, we won't.
Yeah. It's unlikely. I'm like, no, I couldn't have them all done the week before because of the statistics I'm all done.
Yeah.
Okay, so this astronaut food, you're not dehydrating things, are you?
No, we're doing, like, basically it's going to be kind of instant pudding mix, except we're going to have all the ingredients. Like, we'll have to do the cocoa powder and the sugar, and then we're like, okay, so this is what it would be like when an astronaut gets it with all the powdery stuff, and now we have to add water. Ooh, and then we make chocolate pudding.
I went to space camp and it was totally fun. They're gonna love it. Although I had actual dehydrated food that I got to eat,
so
it's a little different.
Nice.
But they're gonna really.
We're gonna watch some YouTube videos from that Canadian astronaut because he made some of him eating his like opening and eating his food and making
yep.
it. And he's just so excited. He's like, oh no, this is the fun part. And then he just pours water and he's like, ooh.
My son watched those and he was like,
he's so
he loved
fun.
It. So yeah,
I think
it's great.
No dehydrating will take place. So they do that back on Earth.
So when is the last Sunday? Or has it already? Is it the end of May?
The next week. This Sunday. This coming. It's the Sunday before Memorial Day. Is that this week?
Memorial Day is here. So
oh, yes. The 22nd is the last one. We're closed Memorial Day weekend. The 22nd is the last one. Two more Sundays. Until the fall.
This all makes sense now. I saw an email about galactic Oreos recently, and I was like,
what are you talking about?
What is going on?
Yeah, what are galactic Oreos? I read it, but I kept like reading a little bit. Like, what are galactic
Oreos? Well, I've got pictures of those out here.
Oh, really?
Let me show you our beautiful stuff. Basically, so they signed up, and then I bought two packs of Oreos just in case they brought friends, but no one brought friends, so everyone got to make 10 Oreos. And we scrape the cream out and then mix it in with a little vanilla frosting and then split that frosting into at least two different colors. I did blue and purple, some did like pink and white or blue and pink, whatever you want with food dye. Then you sort of swirl those together, but not mix because you don't want the colors to blend. And then you put that back inside the Oreo, cap the Oreo, and then on the outside you put like pearl dust and edible
oh,
butter
wow.
things.
Oh, wow.
So nice.
That's amazing.
So they enjoyed that a lot. Let's see where that gallery is.
That'll be pictures in next month's meeting, right?
Yeah, it will. I mean, I guess. See the.
No, no, I'm not saying you don't see it now, but we'll have a printed out picture.
Oh, and then they made little packages of, we put them in cupcake holders and then just bundled them up in a nice little glittery pipe cleaner. You can flip back and forth between them.
Oh God!
If you see an audience, people, you've gone too far.
That's amazing.
They were having a blast.
That is really really cool.
Doing all this cool stuff. Bye.
Are we done with the reference reports?
Yeah, I'm gonna move to accept both like March and April.
Second one.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay.
On to the financials.
Sorry, I'm distracted by
goodness.
You can do a few cookies.
They look so good.
I'm always distracted.
Some of them did not make it home. They were just like, oh no, I've got one too many to fit in this package. I guess I'll have to eat it.
And then there's an uneven number, so you have to eat one more.
I know, it's just a vicious cycle.
Exactly. Is that a moto?
Hmm?
Kind of the other.
Oh, yes. Where did it? Oh, yeah. I think it's a Galaxy moto. I can't recall.
New phone?
My phone.
You got a new phone?
I've had a new phone.
Oh.
I just don't. It's waterproof.
Ooh. You gonna test that theory?
No.
Like they do on TV.
Yeah, I'd be like, I'm not gonna tempt fate.
Well, I mean, we could do the March in April, but honestly, the March is kind of redundant.
Yeah.
Okay. I think we should just do April, don't you think?
I'm just looking at the red.
I mean, you can look at March.
I wanna compare the red.
Yeah, I mean, you can look at them, obviously.
We are into May already.
Yes, we are.
You know.
And the countdown to the end of the year.
Can we find out what's happening with the custodial supplies?
No, I think it's partly because I bought more expensive stuff. I upgraded the paper towels and now I've gotten better prices for them. And, oh, I know why, the light bulbs. All the LED light bulbs I bought for the cans went to that line too. Which I had forgotten, because that was several hundred dollars. I mean, obviously we can look at March and accept it, but it is kind of redundant. And my concern about fines has held true, we're not even gonna hit 16.
No.
Which I had projected would maybe hit 16, I think maybe we'll hit 15. So that's why for fiscal 17, I had asked to increase the book budget, because we have to meet state requirements. Probably gonna have to do the same thing next year, because I just don't think the fines are gonna sustain, and I don't see them growing. So, but I think we should be all right this year.
So I see that we've book purchasing is going well.
Yes. And there should be more fine money coming in. I got notice from the state that not fine money, state aid.
Yeah.
Well, there should be more fine money.
We've gotten $10,000 that have changed.
Right. The state aid has come in, but I haven't gotten official notification that it's been put in all the accounts yet, so
okay.
That's why then it's not reflected.
Right.
But they should be there. They'll be reflected next month. I really am too. Well, this electricity bill that came in this week went up. It went from 18, 19 to 25 or whatever. So I'm looking at it going, okay, our payment plan has kicked in.
Mm-hmm.
It was our first payment on the $30,000 that we got over 3 years. So I was like, okay, so now what's going to have to happen? This is why I wanted to watch the kilowatts, because
right.
What was supposed to happen was supposed to be almost a wash.
Mm-hmm.
So next month and the months that after, the $900 should come down. Let's see.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I
might dork out and actually keep track and just take out the payment plan section of it and
just
watch kilowatts only.
Yeah, I was going to do that.
Just out of curiosity?
I was
going to
track
dork. Yeah, okay.
No,
if you're
going to
do that anyway, then great.
Yeah, no, I was going to do that anyway. Are you kidding me?
All right, cool. Because I would actually really like to see, like, progressively with the...
We invest a lot of money in these projects.
Exactly.
And I was very hopeful for
it.
And I love them. And I think they give much better light, much cleaner light, much brighter light. I love the fact we can control them. I love them. But I do also want to see the net gain, especially when in a lot of the cases, I set these lights below standard.
Right.
And he was surprised that I did that. And he said, oh, you're going to save lots of money. I said, oh, good, let me save lots of money. And I haven't seen it saved yet. So. We'll
it's still very brand new, though. Not
it is very
yeah.
brand new. It is very brand
but
new.
But I'm
going to
be curious
we'll
for sure.
To have
see.
To watch our kilowatts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So maybe we could come up with some sort of
the
Excel
wrench,
spreadsheet or something.
The wrench in the plan is always the AC.
Yeah.
And we're going
that's
into
true.
AC season.
Yeah.
And the units on the roof are very big. They're older now, so they're not exactly terribly efficient.
True.
So
they have been repaired recently, so I'm hoping
right.
there won't be a lot of loss that
hopefully.
Is unnecessary. So.
Hopefully.
Yep.
Hopefully. But we can then compare that, though, against last summer and see
exactly.
how the kilowatts
yeah.
do. No, no, I have a plan, I'm gonna try to.
I'm really excited about that.
I'm a geek too, you know, and.
Yeah.
They had to convince me very hard that would work.
Do you guys need more time to read, or can I make a move to accept these financial reports from March and April?
Yeah, a second.
All in favor?
Aye. Now we stop moving, I mean.
Okay.
All right. Maintenance, well, you guys will have to do a field trip and go see the carpeting. It looks really, really nice, we got a slightly darker color than we usually do, simply because I'm absolutely ridiculously tired of replacing carpet, because it gets a grody.
Yeah.
But it looks really, really good, I also got a slightly higher, I got the same, the council, all right, Town Hall, Council on Aging also do carpeting projects, and I got the same quality of carpet as Council on Aging, because we have a lot of foot traffic.
Yes.
Town Hall has a much lower, much, much lower foot traffic quotient, so we got a higher quality, so it's really a denser. And you, when we walked in, like, oh, you can feel it, you can tell, it's a much nicer, it's a much higher quality carpet.
Yeah.
For only hundreds of dollars, you know, not, it didn't double the price, we're like, oh, you can get the, you know, the lower grade for $5,000, you can get the better stuff that'll last you longer for $5,500, I'm like, okay, yeah, let's just do that. So you definitely have to do a field trip for that.
Cool.
I haven't done anything about the cameras yet, I still intend to, because, just our cameras are not, they just don't do the job. But the heating project and the lighting project kind of took over my facilities managing time, so. And the next is the lighting project is complete, and it, as we were just saying, it looks great. There is one room that was overlooked, and I have asked prices for how much it would be to do a similar job in there, and I have not gotten the prices yet. The history room, for some reason, it's got one, you know, the domes we had in here, it still has one of those, and it's got six can lights, and I want this, I want a few of these in there, and get rid of the fluorescent in there and the can lights.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how much they are. I have no idea how much one of these units costs. I've been told that room needs at least two. We also want to add them into the corner of the kids' room. We want to get rid of those pendants that are hanging there that are useless, and there's no heat or light from them. And we want to replace that and put in two of these as well to finish off that corner. But I need to find the prices and to see how much that will cost to do that. So that's the last of the lighting. The dumpster's gone, the container's gone, we're all very happy about that.
Very cool.
Yeah. Foundation news. I have had a few conversations with the current board and the board of director who wants out. We are planning a meeting to sit down and go over the paperwork and to see exactly what's been done, what still needs to be done, what the status is. The person that I'm hoping signs on is, we've had long talks, and they've got some initial paperwork, and they want to be part of those meetings before they commit to signing on. I'm really, really hopeful that the foundation actually does become a foundation. So, fingers crossed. That's the news on that. Oh, well, new business isn't new anymore. new business, the town meeting was May 12th.
No, it wasn't. It was May 10th.
Oh.
This is May 12th.
Oh, it is. You're right,
yes,
May 10th.
I happen to know that.
Oh, my heavens. Yeah. All right, it was Tuesday.
Yeah.
I'm taking it up anyway.
Doesn't matter.
The election is Saturday,
mm-hmm.
for those of you running. And, yeah, no, really, run fast.
Yeah.
And then for Sue Ann Tom, who I'm surprised she isn't getting it, but she is on the ballot for Saturday, so she should be our new trustee once you get signed in and sworn in. So everybody go vote Saturday. And I already told you that the townwide beat is the Martian, and you have the brochure, so pick up the book and read it, listen to it. It is also on Overdrive, if you want to read the electronic version, which somehow feels appropriate for the Martian, but I'm not going
to
do it.
I listen to the audiobook.
That's what Melissa said, the audio is better, and I'm feeling that it is. I'm reading it. I started reading it as an ebook because that's what I had access to, and I turned that back in. So now I'm reading a real book, And it is, the humor of it, I like. The science of it is a little monotonous.
Mm.
And I like science to a certain extent, but it's just when you spend four pages talking about cubic square inches of, you know,
matter. See, I'm going to like that. I'm going to like that.
You'll enjoy it.
I can't wait.
But the humor is great. The character is very humorous, and especially in the situation he's in. So yeah. I like the character. I'm plotting. I know it'll pick up, but I think I probably should be listening to it, although I really am not overly fond of audiobooks.
Yeah.
But
sometimes it is easier to digest that way if it's
right.
stuff that you end up skimming because you don't
yeah.
feel like,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
Well, but sometimes when somebody else reads the science, it's easier to
comprehend. That's what I mean.
Sometimes.
I listened to Jules Verne, 40,000 Leagues Under the Sea. 20,000. 20,000. I just doubled it.
He went
further in my book. 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea.
He went deep when he wanted to.
Modern technology
yeah.
went further. 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. And the science there, and I love plate tectonics. I mean, I love that whole
mm-hmm.
theory. And that bored me. And I tried
sure.
listening to it.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh my goodness, how did this ever become a classic? It's really dry. Really dry.
Yeah,
there's
been a movie like that I've started and I have been
really
able to
dry.
Continue. Yeah.
The Martian, however, has a lot of science. But like I said, the character's really entertaining. So
mm.
I like that.
Cool.
Yeah.
Have you seen the movie yet?
No. I'm going to see it when we show it.
Cool.
I'm
gonna like it.
No, I told everyone when it is. When is it?
The 24th, you said?
24th
at 6 p.m.
I'll just stay later that day. I love that movie.
It's a good movie. It's a very good movie.
Yeah.
24th at 6.
Tavis isn't sure if he wants to see it or not. So just be like, well, if you don't want to see it, I'll watch it with Steph.
They'll be fun. They'll be fun.
He doesn't want to see Deadpool.
He doesn't?
Why not?
We just got the video.
It's too vulgar for him.
No.
Now. My sensibility.
That's what I'm watching when I go home tonight, actually.
Deadpool?
For the second time.
Yes. I haven't watched it yet. We just got the video.
It's fantastic.
I don't know if you'll like it.
No?
I think that she'll like most of it. Maybe not all of it. There'll be some parts that you might not like, but you'll like it.
Okay, now
which
I'm intrigued.
Which one?
Deadpool.
Oh, okay. I haven't seen it.
So I like superheroes and stuff anyway, but what...
What
I like about it.
Okay.
I'm going
to
call
it. Karen's trying
to
rail
us. Before you do that, we need
yes.
to acknowledge the fact that this is your last meeting.
Yes.
So
yes.
thank you for 6 years?
Mm-hmm.
Seven?
Thank you.
Seven?
Wow.
Yeah, that odd number.
That
yeah.
odd
oh,
number.
Because you jumped in on a year and, well, yeah, there was that kerfuffle. And, yeah.
It's amazing.
Well, congrats. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Don't be a stranger. Please drop by.
I will. Yeah. Well, I have two books to return.
Well, there we go.
Don't just throw them in the box and leave.
So thank you.
Great.
Cool.
All right. I don't have anything else. Anyone else?
Okay.
Good.
That's the end. 8:24.
All right. Okay.